To all who come to this happy place, welcome.
Now, we know from earlier videos this month that the Haunted Mansion was originally going to be a walkthrough attraction. An attraction similar to Tarzan's Treehouse today, where instead of boarding a ride vehicle, you walk through the entire thing. Except, the difference from Tarzan's Treehouse would be the special effects were cranked up to 11 and you'd be inside. A ghostly butler would lead you through the mansion every so often stopping you, telling you a story about a room, and then an effect would happen that would be influenced in some way by the story. Like a giant hairy hand swiping at your butler. You know, just fun stuff. Eventually, WED, or Walt Disney Imagineering as they are known today, was confronted with the issue of ride capacity. A very real issue in theme parks that is apparently plaguing Star Wars Galaxy's Edge right now. Capacity meaning how many guests they can put through an attraction per hour. Pirates of the Caribbean is a wonderful example of an attraction with great ride capacity. The problem with a walkthrough attraction like what the Haunted Mansion was going to be is the capacity would be super, super low. So low that in fact, one time Disney put forward the idea of building two identical Haunted Mansions right next to each other. At some point, Disney decided to change the Haunted Mansion from a walkthrough to an Omnimover-style attraction, similar to Adventure Thru Inner Space in Tomorrowland. But remnants of a walkthrough Haunted Mansion do exist today at both Disneyland and Walt Disney World, and heck, every Haunted Mansion across the globe. The stretching room scene, present in every single Haunted Mansion, is basically what the walkthrough would have been. Guests being guided into a room, a host of sorts telling a story, and then the room shifting and changing and special effects happening to reflect that story. The Hall of Changing Portraits at Disneyland is another remnant of the walkthrough, where story and effects are presented to you, but you're not in your doom buggy quite yet. The interactive queue at Walt Disney World is also a really good example of this, except the tricks and effects aren't as advanced as they would have been in the original mansion. But let me turn the question over to you. What is your favorite walkthrough attraction at Disneyland or Walt Disney World? Doesn't have to be the Haunted Mansion. It could be Tarzan's Treehouse like we talked about earlier, the Sleeping Beauty walkthrough, the Redwood Creek Challenge Trail, any of these. Let me know down in the comments and I will see you all a little later.